Why is it so important to share your beautiful bed ideas with the clients, your colleagues, or your manager? And I'm talking about creative campaigning, improving workflow processes, or concepting work-related ideas. You know what I'm talking about. I've seen people feel unrecognized, unappreciated, and just simply sad because of that. And I think that's not fair to yourself and not to the people you work with to hold back on your ideas. My name is Sven Oensen and this is Marketing Mondays. And today I'm going to share with you why I think you should share your beautiful bad ideas. I realize most of the time this is happening because of two reasons. One is lack of confidence. People think their idea is not good enough or not perfected enough, or others have better ideas, or they just need more time to really articulate their ideas in a good way so others will listen to it. And the other one is an insecure surrounding or work environment. People feel they cannot talk to the manager or he's not listening, or it's a very competitive work environment with colleagues really chasing each other for the best ideas. And there's just a lack of trust to share your idea with the people around you. So in fact, this means your fear is killing your idea before it's even out there. And I get that. I think I experienced all of these circumstances myself, and sometimes I even did hold back on ideas myself because I didn't feel secure enough at that moment. But every time I did that, I wasn't happy about it. And I really personally think that being happy and feeling happy while you work in your work environment with your colleagues, with your manager, is the most important thing in giving you the chance and becoming successful in what you do. So here's my arguments, my list for you to feel more confident and to start sharing your ideas. I think it's my top 7. Number 1, someone will benefit of your idea. Number 2, you need time, funding, or help from others to realize your idea. Number 3, talking what's on your mind involves others in your thought processes instantly. Number 4, the longer you sit on your ideas to perfect them, the bigger the chance that they will be outdated before you're ready. Number 5, it's really fulfilling to work on your own projects and create opportunities for your own projects. Number 6, and if it's really such a bad idea, you can improve on it and learn from it and go from there. Number 7, by pitching your ideas, you actually learn how to pitch your ideas better. That's good, I think. So I've been a manager in different companies and I can tell you this. You've been hired for a reason. People think you can perform a certain job, or they think you can learn to perform a certain job. They have trust in you. And that is a great reason to give something back and to participate in what's going on in that company. And remember, nobody is perfect. No, nobody is perfect. And just imagine that your company tries to get this new major client and they're really in the sales process at the moment. And you come up with an idea and how to maybe improve the social media strategy and performance of that certain potential client. If you share this idea to your colleagues or your CEO or manager who's ever involved in that process, they can really benefit from that. So by sharing this idea, you might have sparked some new ideas on and sales opportunities for your company to grow and to perform better. And that's great. And remember, everybody has 30 seconds to spare. And 30 seconds is all you need to articulate your idea. So if you're walking around on your job today with this imperfect idea in your head you want to share with someone, look around and find that person that you can share it with, or that can help you share the idea with someone. So here are some extra tips on how you can do this. So if you indeed have only 30 seconds for this pitch, be very specific. And this 30 seconds won't let you discuss all the topics and all the details. The only reason you need this 30 seconds pitch is to get an appointment. Don't forget that. If you have more time, it's always better, I believe, to visualize your ideas, to get some creative concepts that people can see what you're talking about. Maybe it's a chart, or maybe it's a video, or maybe it's just a picture or of a product. Make it visual somehow. And if you need to write a memo about it, make it short, one page maximum. And don't be too possessive about this idea. Give others the chance to play with it, to mold it, to shape it to their likings, and to add to your idea. Be very open-minded about it. And most of all, don't let fear hold you back. So let's get happy and be happy wherever you're working and what you're working on. Start sharing your imperfect ideas with the people around you. Even the best idea need work to get realized. Don't forget that.